Okay, guys. Well, I have some weather updates for you. After two or three wet days, we had showers and sprinkles and different things, cold air, windy conditions, low clouds, fog. We've had it all. And we're going to dry out for about two or three days. With today, this afternoon, we started drying out. And today's Monday. Well, now it's Tuesday. Tuesday and Wednesday look like dry days. Late Thursday looks like the rain's gonna arrive, probably after 7 or 8 p.m. in the evening. That's when the rain's gonna come in. That'll be the first storm. That looks to bring about a tenth to a third of an inch of rain for the valleys, up to a half an inch in our mountains to our east of Phoenix, such as Gila County, Globe, those areas. We'll see around a half inch of rain, with around a tenth to a third of an inch here. That's a fast-moving storm. Then late on the 20th, the second storm begins to barrel itself in here. And it's going to produce strong gusty southerly to southwesterly winds up to 30 miles an hour. And a cold frontal band that's going to produce moderate to heavy rainfall with embedded thunderstorms. That's going to move through. Another storm moves through Saturday. Okay, so we got Thursday night, then Friday, another storm. Saturday into early Sunday, a storm. That'll be the third storm. And then Monday, late at Monday afternoon through Tuesday afternoon, another storm. That'll be the fourth storm to go through the area. And then after that, we dry out to about the 29th. And I'm looking at another potential storm, a fifth storm. This one looks to be more of a cutoff low type of situation. I believe areas of northern Arizona and New Mexico will get most of this moisture from the fifth storm. I don't believe the valleys down here will see anything more than clouds and breezes and cooler temperatures. I'm not predicting rain right now with the fifth system. Okay, that could change. I will keep you posted on that one. That's still, let's see, 7 to 10 days out, so a lot can happen with the models during that time frame. But some models are predicting some other type of storm system. And then it looks like we're gonna go into the 31st. It looks like another weak storm system will develop into the 1st of February. That looks like a very weak one. Clouds, some winds, and maybe some light showers in the high country, but no rain for the valleys right now. So, like I said, the models are having a tough time what to do. A lot of them are starting to build a ridge of high pressure off the west coast. And that would make sense after a long, stormy January for much of the west coast. It makes sense to have a long, prolonged high pressure system of some type setting itself up off the coast and giving us a major break from the storminess that we've had in December and January. But with the way the winter's been going, I won't be surprised if we don't see a break very long for more than a week. We had a week break, the 3rd, January 3rd through the 9th, through the 8th was a dry period. On the 9th, we had some rain. Then we dried out another 3 or 4 days and we had some more rain. And now we're drying out for another 3 days, and then we're going to have a week of rain off and on across the area. This rain event is going to last the 19th through the 25th across the region. And we could see 2 to 3 inches of rain here in the low deserts of Arizona, and up to 5 inches in our higher elevations, and up to 40 inches of snow around the Flagstaff area. That's a lot of snow, guys. That's a lot of snow. And that's mainly going to be on the peaks. The city could see up to over 2 feet of snow over the periods of these storms, if not more than that. So we're going to be keeping a very close eye on that to see exactly what happens. So we'll keep you guys posted. It's still early in the game. I won't be surprised if we see more storminess after the 25th. It will not surprise me one bit if we continue the wet pattern, like some models suggest. They're kind of backing away from that idea now, and they're bringing in a strong ridge of high pressure to develop off the west coast for a good 7 to 15 days. And that is also very possible too, and more likely a scenario to have a strong ridge of high pressure after such a long stormy period. We'll keep you guys posted on this, on the developing weather. But a series of storms come in, and I'll keep you guys up to date on them and keep tracking them here for you and post them so you guys can view the storms. So we'll keep you guys posted, and we will talk to you all later. Be safe during the upcoming winter weather.